Diplo Thomas Wesley Pence, born November 10, 1978, known professionally as Diplo, is an American DJ, songwriter, and record producer based in Los Angeles, California. He is the co-creator and lead member of the electronic dancehall music project Major Lazer, a member of the supergroup LSD with Sia and Labyrinth, a member of electronic duo Jack U with producer and DJ Skrillex, and a member of Silk City with Mark Ronson. He founded and manages record company Mad Decent, as well as co-founding the non-profit organization Heaps Decent. Among other jobs, he has worked as an English teacher in Japan and a school teacher in Philadelphia. His 2013 EP, Revolution, debuted at number 68 on the US Billboard 200. The EP's title track was later featured in a commercial for Hyundai and is featured on the WWE 2K16 soundtrack. During his rise to fame, Diplo worked with British musician MIA, an artist who was credited with giving him exposure in his early career. Later, he and fellow MIA producer Sar Switch created a gimmick and dancehall project and cartoon series titled Major Lazer. Since then, Diplo has worked on production and mixed projects with many other pop artists, such as Gwen Stefani, Diane Warren, Britney Spears, Madonna, Shakira, Beyonce, Ellie Goulding, No Doubt, Justin Bieber, Usher, Snoop Dogg, Trippie Redd, Chris Brown, CL, G-Dragon, Bad Bunny, M, and Poppy. His alias, short for Diplodocus, derives from his childhood fascination with dinosaurs. Early life. Diplo was born on November 10, 1978, in Tupelo, Mississippi, the son of Barbara Jean, Nick Cox, and Thomas Pence. He is of German and English descent. The influence of homegrown rap played a key role in helping shape his production style. He spent the majority of his youth in Miami, where he got a taste for the characteristic Miami bass. He began attending the University of Central Florida in 1997. During his time at UCF, he became a DJ at local radio station WPRK, the radio station at Rollins College. He moved to Philadelphia to continue his studies at Temple University, where he first garnered attention as a DJ after frequently running into fellow DJ Low Budget. The two began throwing parties under the hood on Holotronic's moniker in 2003 as a way of maintaining control of what they were able to play during DJ gigs in Philadelphia. The success of these parties allowed the two to release mixtapes, both separate and together, gathering acclaim across the country. One such mixtape, Never Scared, was named one of the New York Times' top 10 albums of 2003, and the Holotronic's name became synonymous with parties featuring guests like Mel Kimala, Bun B, Spag Rock, MIA, among others. Holotronic's sound has been described as disparate genres to be smashed together for maximum attention-grabbing impact and aesthetic, which takes from the organic, cohesive, whole aesthetic of eights such as Bun B, Lil Jon, Drama, MIA, Busta Rhymes, and others. Diplo accentuated the club aesthetic of his Holotronic's music for a more reflective sound on his solo debut, Florida, which was released on the Ninja Tune imprint, Big Dada Records. The album Florida was pressed twice, first with a CD and the second with a CD and DVD. The DVD was created by System D-128, another artist who has collaborated with Diplo on some audio and video projects. Before Florida's DVD accompaniment, another DVD surfaced called Diplo Banged in Libya, which was released by Money Studies, the first label to release a solo project by Diplo under his original DJ name Diplodocus. It was a 45 RPM record called The Imagine, for which there is also a music video. System D-128 directed. Similar to the Florida DVD, Banged in Libya is an experimental audio and video mix of some of Diplo's original music blended with a number of other unidentified sources. His particular affinity for one genre of music called Bale Funk, or Favela Funk, would spawn a series of mixtapes, Favela on Blast, Favela Strikes Back, which served to bring the Brazilian dance music of the ghettos to the United States. It was not long before his hit on Holotronic's parties would provide him the success necessary to move to the next logical step and build a studio where music would become his full-time focus. With this goal in mind, Diplo built the Mausoleum, a video studio, recording studio, record label office, gallery, and event space in Philadelphia. Since its inception, the Mausoleum has become the home to recordings by artists like Christina Aguilera, Shakira, MIA, Santa Gold, Spag Rock, Plastic Little, Black Star, Paper Rude Gangsters, and hosted concerts by Glass Candy, Scream, Boys Noize, Nikos Gunn, and more. After hearing one of his songs in 2004, MIA approached Diplo when he was gin one night at the Fabric Club in London. Coincidentally, Diplo was playing our songs Galang and Fire Fire as she entered the club, which he got from a worker at a D magazine. Diplo added, "She came through and she wanted to meet me cause she'd heard my single and the funk mix from one of her and RS, and she just thought I was right up her alley." Besides me being a white dude from Florida and her being a Sri Lankan girl in England, everything else was the same. We were both film graduates, listened to all the same music when we were kids, we're going in the same direction right now in music. It was amazing. I always wanted to make a beat with her, but all my beats were really shitty at the time. The two eventually collaborated on a mixtape, Piracy Funds Terrorism Volume 1, where Lara track Acaplus were mashed with other artists' songs and was mentioned as albums of the year from the New York Times and Pitchfork Media. The two continued to work together after the release. He was the tour DJ on her 2005 Aguilera tour. Diplo continued to work with MIA and, through her, met London DJ Switch. Together, they created the Grammy-nominated trap Paper Planes, peaking at number 4 on the Billboard Hot 100 in 2015. During an interview with Rolling Stone, MIA said that Diplo resented her rise to fame in 2005, that he tried to hold her back, and fought with her about becoming successful. Mad Decent main article. Mad Decent. From this, Diplo went from an unknown DJ to taking off as a producer, landing him collaborations with artists like Shakira, Robin, Kid Cudi, Bruno Mars, No Doubt and Snoop Dogg, as well as work with Melka, Kid Sister, Diane Warren, Alex Clare, Rella Tomasi, Amanda Blanc and Dark Meat. After taking a trip to Brazil to investigate the favela music scene, and fascinated with the energy the scene had to offer, Diplo decided to import a dance funk group Bond to hold from Brazil for release on his Mad Decent record label, also the housed within the Mausoleum. This group would serve to define funk karaoke in the United States, spawning a host of others to join the movement. Diplo also spent some time documenting the music and the favelas of Brazil. Although favela funk remained an interest, the Favela on Blast documentary just saw release in 2009, his Mad Decent imprint would serve as a blank palette for Diplo to showcase the myriad different sounds he had come across while touring around the world. September 2009 even saw Diplo travel to China to play with Steve Aoki at a show organized by promoters Split Works. Diplo quickly developed a reputation for his extensive touring. In the April 2010 issue of Rolling Stone, Diplo was touted as one of 40 reasons to be excited about music. This kind of jet-setting pushed his label far beyond the favela funk genre with which it initially began. Since its foundation in 2005, Diplo's Mad Decent label has released music by Santigold, Bar, Lil Jon, Gucci Mane, Peter Bjorn and John, Rusko, Bosco Del Rey, Burica Sound System, Savage Skulls, Dana Sipa, Oliver Tibbetst, Jamie Fanatic, Dowster, Boy 8, Bit, and Popo. As Mad Decent continues to grow and release tracks by big-name artists, Diplo's solo career continues to grow at the same rate. He's produced for artists such as Beyonce, Justin Bieber, Lil Wayne, Britney Spears, Whale, Chris Brown, Ariana Grande, 2 Chainz, Travis Porter, Usher, Azealia Banks, Iggy Azalea, and Nelly Nottage. On October 16, 2015, Diplo released Be Right There along with fellow producer Sar Sleepy Tom. The single charted in multiple countries and has over 100 million streams on Spotify. On April 23, 2016, Beyonce released her critically acclaimed album, Lemonade. Diplo produced 2 tracks on the album, All Night, and one of the 3 singles, Hold Up. The album debuted at number 1 on the US Billboard 200 and was certified platinum on June 8, 2016. Along with producing tracks on Beyonce's Lemonade, Diplo collaborated with Canadian DJ duo Zeg's Dead on the release Blame, which featured Swedish singer Leifend. The track was officially released on July 14, 2016, via Zeg's Dead SoundCloud. Major Lazer. Diplo's first collaborated full-length record was with Switch, this time under the guise of Major Lazer. Diplo incorporates such disparate influences as Miami bass and Bale funk into the high-tech eclecticism of his productions. 38 After landing a deal with Dentown Records before even recording a note of music, Diplo and Switch set out for Jamaica to record a project that, like most of Diplo's projects before it, would highlight the little-known subgenre is, this time of Jamaica's dancehall scene. 27 The two received support by many already established Jamaican artists such as Vibes Cartel, Elephant Man and His Thing, and the resulting record Guns Don't Kill People. Lazer 2 also featured vocals from Santigold, Amanda Blanc, Nina Sky, Ricky Blaze and more. 39 When discussing the Major Lazer project, Diplo described the dancehall sound as being the end of the world. All the little influences house, seca, oldies, R&B, jazz, it all ends up in Jamaica. 40 The track Pon D Floor from Guns Don't Kill People, Lazer 2 was sampled for Beyonce's single Run the World, Girls. 41 Major Lazer's first album was followed up with an EP, Lazer's Never Die, which was released in 2010. Switch left Major Lazer in 2011, and it was replaced by DJs Jillianer and Walshy Fire. A second album, Free the Universe, was scheduled to be released in November 2012 but was delayed to February 2013, and then to April 15. It features artists such as Ezra Koenig, Bruno Mars, War 21, Wycliffe, The Pretty Squad, Shaggy, Tyga, Flux Pavilion and Winter Gordon. 42 On February 8, 2015, during the Grammy Awards ceremony, Diplo revealed details of the third major Lazer album. He confirmed that the album would incorporate artists such as Ariana Grande, Ellie Goulding and Pusha T. It is called Peace is the Mission. The first single, Lean On, is a collaboration with French producer DJ Snake and features vocals from Danish recording artist M.O. The second single, Powerful, featuring Ellie Goulding and Terrace Riley, was released simultaneously with the album on June 1, 2015. 43 On November 11, 2015, Lean On became Spotify's most streamed song of all time with over 800 million streams to date. Along with the streaming title, the official video for Lean On became one of the most viewed videos on YouTube. It currently has more than 2 billion views. 44 Along with the streaming and viewing milestones, Lean On would also go on to achieve double platinum status. 45 On July 22, 2016, the group released the single Cold Water, a collaboration with Canadian artist Justin Bieber and Danish singer M.O. The track has already reached over 200 million streams on Spotify, and achieved international commercial success, reaching number one in multiple countries. Their upcoming album, Music is the Weapon, will feature collaborations with Sia, The Weeb and Ty Dolla $ign. On November 29, 2016, Major Lazer and Bad Royale released My Number, a track that samples 5-4-4-6, That's My Number, which Pitchfork describes as a genre-defining classic from legendary ska/reggae group Toots and the Maytals. This release contained newly recorded vocals from frontman Toots Hibbert specifically designed for Major Lazer, which changed the original lyrics to incorporate the group into the song while keeping the original melody. Jack U is an American duo made up of Skrillex and Diplo. Jack U's debut performance took place at the Mad Decent Block Party in San Diego on September 15, 2013, which is a nationwide tour that record label Mad Decent puts together in order to showcase different artists signed to the label. Diplo announced the project by releasing the Mad Decent Block Party lineup with Jack U playing at multiple stops on the tour. After some guessing by many of who Jack U was, Diplo finally came out to reveal that Jack U, meets Skrillex and Diplo together after their New York debut at Electric Zoo was cancelled in late August. The duo would soon return to the city for something bigger. On December 31, 2014, Jack U sold out Madison Square Garden for one of their biggest performances to date. The duo had support from Rudimental, Yellow Claw and $AP Ferg. On February 27, 2015 they released Skrillex and Diplo Present Jack U, a co-release between their respective labels Esla and Mad Decent. It featured tracks with 2 Chainz, Kesha, Justin Bieber, Ayla Nutridge and Missy Elliott. The first single Take You There featuring Kesha was the lead single on the duo's debut album. The single was released as the lead on October 4, 2014. It reached number 16 on the UK dance chart. The official second single, Where Are You Now, was released simultaneously with the album. The song, which took both artists in a different direction, featured a collaboration with Canadian pop star Justin Bieber. Peaking at number 8 on the Billboard Hot 100, and number 3 on the UK singles chart, Where Are You Now became the duo's largest hit on both charts thus far. The song would also go on to peak at number 3 in Australia, which was the highest charting for the single worldwide. The song a huge success in Europe as well, reaching the top 10 in Sweden and Finland, and the top 20 in Norway, the Czech Republic, Denmark and Slovakia. The final place that had charting success was Bieber's home country, Canada, where it would end up peaking at number 6. On March 29, 2015, Jack U closed the main stage at Ultra Music Festival in Miami. In 2016, the duo won 2 Grammy Awards for Grammy Award for Best Dance Album for Skrillex and Diplo Present Jack U and Grammy Award for Best Dance for Where Are You Now? With Justin Bieber. The latter was also Bieber's first Grammy. They played 2 sold-out shows including Coachella Valley Music Festival in Indio, California and Lollapalooza in Sao Paulo, Brazil. Florida is the first studio album Diplo produced in 2004. This album was under the label Big Data. This album created Diplo's genre of electronic/reggae/hip-hop music. LSD is a pop supergroup composed of Diplo, Australian singer Sia, and British musician Labyrinth. The trio have released 5 singles thus far, with their song Thunderclouds being featured in the commercial for the Samsung Galaxy Note 9. Their singles Genius and Audio have seen official remixes from producers Banks and Sid, respectively. LSD's debut album Labyrinth, Sia and Diplo Present, LSD was released on April 12, 2019. Silk City on January 2, 2018 Diplo announced a new project with British DJ and singer Mark Ronson, entitled Silk City. The duo released their debut single Only Can Get Better featuring Daniel Merriweather on May 23, 2018. Their second single, Feel About You featuring Nate B, was released on July 20, 2018. The duo's third single, Loud, saw Diplo reunite with previous collaborators Goldlink and Essigner. Their fourth and most recent single features British singer-slash-songwriter Dua Lipa, called Electricity, which was released on September 5, 2018. The music video was released on the same day. Additional work beyond Major Lazer and Mad Decent, Diplo has continued to show support for all the little influences, the lesser-known music scenes around the globe. Most recently his focus shifted to the bounce scene in New Orleans, Louisiana for a television piece commissioned by Current TV 59. Diplo was nominated for Non-Classical Producer of the Year at the 55th Grammy Awards and 58th Grammy Awards. 60 as of 2014, Diplo has a late night show on BBC Radio 1/1XTRA on Saturdays 11 o'clock p.m., 1 a.m. GMT, called Diplo and Friends, where he curates mixes from some of the biggest names in dance music. 61 Diplo also has several syndicated Diplo and Friends shows in the United States in Boston, Bakersfield, Cleveland, Columbus, Las Vegas, Spokane, Albuquerque, Lafayette, Denver, and most notably on Los Angeles 98.7 every Sunday at 9 p.m. 62 beginning on October 2, 2015. Diplo, Gillianer, Walshy Fire and Eric Hamilton debuted Laser Sound on Apple Music's Beats 1. The newest radio show, carried by Diplo and the Major Lazer crew, consists of interviews, moments on tour and brand new music. The show is on the air every other Saturday of the month. 63 Throughout 2015 and 2016, Diplo performed with Major Lazer and Jack U on numerous live TV and award shows. He performed on The Tonight Show starring Jimmy Fallon, Good Morning America, the Internet Radio Music Festival, the NRJ Music Awards, the 2015 Latin Grammy Awards and the 2016 Grammy Awards. In February 2016, Diplo was one of the first and very few mainstream Western artists to perform in Islamabad, Pakistan alongside Edullah Omar, SNKM and Elephant. In 2018, Diplo returned to with Major Lazer for Islamabad's first Mad Decent block party alongside Edullah Omar, SNKM, Talal Al Qureshi, Valentino Khan, Chrome Sparks, Lieri Underground and a host of other acts. In January 2017, Diplo and the Tartik, a house group from Toronto, released a music video titled Waste Time, which was filmed in a warehouse in London. He is up for another two Grammys next month at the 2016, the 59th Annual Grammy Awards, for Album of the Year, for producer of Beyoncé's album A Minute and producer for Justin Bieber's album Purpose. He also sang a song for In Bollywood and Imtiaz Ali's film Jab Harry Met Sale starring Shah Rukh Khan and Anushka Sharma. In 2019, Diplo released the song So Long under the moniker Thomas Wesley, featuring American country singer Kim. In a press release, he stated that there are several forthcoming collaborations with country artists planned following So Long, which included the song Heartless, featuring Morgan Wallen. Personal life: he has two sons, Lockett and Laser, with Catherine Lockhart. Diplo is a soccer and cricket fan and supporter of the U.S. men's national team. He also supports Arsenal FC and has attended 2 Tigrayuano matches. He created a mix for the 2014 World Cup and produced 2018 World Cup official song Live It Up. Diplo purchased a minority share of Phoenix Rising FC of the USL Championship on January 27, 2016. He stated, "I've been really fortunate to travel all over the world and experience different cultures through music. Wherever I am, Jamaica, Spain, England, China, etc., soccer is a social constant. I see soccer the same way I see music, as a connective tissue linking the world's cultures." Diplo is also an active fan of the Philadelphia 76ers, showing support via Snapchat and Instagram whenever he's at their games. He performed with Skrillex and Kai at the Staples Center during halftime at a Los Angeles Clippers game in 2015. Citation needed: on February 24, 2016, Diplo endorsed Bernie Sanders as the Democratic presidential nominee. Sanders' ADXA Revolution is soundtracked by Diplo's 2013 track Revolution. On June 9, 2016, Diplo was featured on the cover of the American entertainment media magazine Billboard. Magazine Billboard.